We are the last of an era and a dying breed. He is everything that he says he is, if not more. In my opinion, probably the greatest world heavyweight champion over the last decade and a half. But the thing that Triple H said that I found most interesting is that he has figured out how to destroy The Undertaker, how to make The Undertaker disappear forever. And really, it was quite simple. All you have to do is beat The Undertaker at WrestleMania. Easier said than done. Now, Triple H has figured out in his mind how he's going to do this. So he's going to take everything that he's accomplished, every accolade, his legacy, his legend, and he's going to throw it all on the table and go for broke. And if he wins, he will be hailed as the game, as the King of Kings. But if he loses, and he will lose, he will become nothing more than a statistic, a name on a long list of people that came before him trying to do the exact same thing, defeat The Undertaker at WrestleMania. Triple H, make no mistake about it. I play no game, and I bow down to no man, especially the King of Kings. At WrestleMania, you will find out what 18 other men that come before you will find out, that I am indeed the last outlaw. And you will also find out what it means to rest in peace.
There ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. When I hear the trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise right out of the ground. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, look way down the river, what do you think I see? I see a band of angels, and they're coming after me.
Well, still to come, contract signings in WWE have a notorious history. After all, champion and challenger are in the ring together. Edge and Alberto Del Rio make their World Heavyweight Championship WrestleMania match official here tonight.
A matchup of mega proportion. The biggest man in all of sports entertainment, The Big Show versus the Big Red Machine, Kane. And that's coming up tonight on Friday Night SmackDown.
We are back on Friday Night SmackDown here in Cleveland, Ohio. It's been an amazing night so far, an amazing week here in WWE, as the announcement of a huge superstar acquisition was announced in Mexico City, Cole.
Yeah, WWE is truly a global company, and last week, WWE signed a worldwide star at a press conference in Mexico City. The man formerly known as Mystico, Sin Cara, announced he's bringing his charismatic, high-flying style to WWE.
Sin Cara brings a style unlike anything we've ever seen here before in WWE. Sin Cara stated, "It's an honor and thrill to be a part of WWE. Looking forward to the challenges that lie ahead."
Yeah, he called it this the defining moment in his career, and he can't wait to perform for the WWE Universe. Mendez actually picked up a victory over Layla last week.
Well, there was a little miscommunication between Layla and Michelle McCool, but nonetheless, a victory for Rosa Mendez.
But still, I'm shocked.
Why are you shocked that Rosa got a victory?
Rosa Mendez has a lot of salsa.
Not enough for me.
Making their way to the ring, Layla and Michelle McCool.
Cool. The aforementioned Lay Cool all set to try to even things up here against Rosa Mendez and Michelle McCool. This is what you were alluding to, the victory of Rosa Mendez over Layla last week.
Well, Michelle McCool was here on commentary with us. And listen, there's always issues in a family, and that's what Lay Cool is. Michelle and Layla are like family. And last week, the argument outside the ring, Layla and Michelle and Rosa getting into it, and then Layla as well. And this all ended up costing Layla the matchup. And I think that this whole thing between Michelle and Layla is being blown completely out of proportion. Bad journalists like you, scab journalists like you, who like to feed gossip to all these newspapers and all these the internet sites and the like, you're the ones that are talking about the problems between Lay Cool. They patched things up. They're ready to go, Josh.
Okay, I saw you talking to Lay Cool earlier. All's good in Lay Cool camp?
It's great.
We'll find out here tonight in tag team action. Michelle McCool starting things off with Beth Phoenix. I know you've certainly been impressed with the Divas as of late and the power that Beth Phoenix brings to the Divas division.
Definitely. Beth Phoenix has a lot of power. You can tell she's been working on the gym for quite some time. She's probably the strongest out of all three of these females, but don't take anything away from Rosa.
Rosa trash talking to Michelle McCool, and here comes Layla.
Well, Rosa looking to build on the momentum that she picked up last week with the victory over Layla.
I love the Paisley-like elf.
Wait, did you see that?
Well, that Layla's wearing.
Well, Rosa looking for the advantage there, comes up empty, and now Layla looking to take over.
Did you see that book? A little bit of teamwork for Lay Cool.
I did, but Lay Cool actually has a lot of friction going on in there, Kim. Kind of like Nicole Richie and Paris Hilton. I can feel a breakup coming here real soon.
2005 is the launch of show back.
I'm trying to talk to him about hip and
so that's like 3 years old.
Bring
up Charlie Sheen or somebody.
Rosa Mendez, the trash talking continues as well. I wanted to hear what Michelle was saying.
Oh, okay. So for once tonight, you laid out to listen to somebody talk.
I think Miss Cool is hurt right here.
Well, she better make a tag to Layla's, which she better do. And here comes the Glamazon.
And Beth Phoenix, who started this match out, now back in control.
Total mismatch right here. Beth Phoenix is just going to run right through her.
Well, Booker, Layla is a former co-Divas champion.
Definitely.
Uh-oh. Layla's in trouble.
And Booker, this is the strength and power you were talking about earlier.
Booyah!
Of the Glamazon, Beth Glamazon. Phoenix. This should do it. There's Michelle McCool. Referee doing a good job. Oh, whoa!
Michelle just caught her with that loaded boot.
Yeah, referee was dealing with Rosa.
Layla with the cover.
You gotta be kidding. There's got to be something in that boot, man.
Here are your winners, Lay Cool.
I guess Lay Cool is just living the simple life here tonight.
See what he did there, Booker? He went back to the hole.
Yeah, he went back to the...
That's why I'm the voice of the WWE.
Well, Lay Cool seems to be back on the same page. Winning cures everything. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, a can't-miss encounter. Two of the most dominant athletes in SmackDown history go one-on-one. It's like Godzilla versus King Kong, or two monster trucks colliding at high speeds. Big Show, Kane, one-on-one, next.
Well, it's a Big Show.
Making its way to the ring, standing 7 feet tall, weighing in at 485 pounds, The Big Show.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the largest athlete on the planet, The Big Show, has had his hands full as of late with the core, but last week, Cole, The Big Show proved he still maintains dominance on Friday nights.
Yeah, very competitive matchup versus Wade Barrett of the core. The Big Show using his strength and power, and then some quickness to beat the count back in the ring and get the count-out victory over Wade Barrett. But as Wade Barrett was recuperating, the other three members of the group would head down to the ring. But this time, The Big Show, victim of the core over many weeks, was ready. Big Show would head out of the ring, grab a steel chair in hand as an equalizer. And I think Big Show finally has figured out, Booker, how to keep the core at bay.
Yeah, Big Show got paid last week. He beat Wade Barrett, but I think Big Show should have left Wade Barrett, I mean, in the dust. He should have just beat that boy down like he stole something, if you know what I'm saying. Like I say, Big Show let Wade Barrett off the hook last week, man.
What a confrontation set to take place right now on Friday Night SmackDown. Two former world champions, the Big Red Monster Kane, and the largest athlete on this planet, The Big Show, one-on-one.
And Josh, we know from what we heard earlier on tonight that the four members of the core will be watching this matchup, hoping that Kane heeds their advice and takes out The Big Show. Booker, you have been in the ring with both of these huge men. What must it be like?
I can only say this right here. I hope the fans really know what they're getting. The Big Show and Kane, two of the biggest athletes in sports entertainment. You're not going to see a matchup like this anywhere in any other sport in the world other than the WWE.
Ooh! And Kane with a big right hand, the near seven-footer, hammered away on Big Show, who goes near 500 pounds.
And we'd like to thank our great friends over at Kmart for being an important part of the WWE Live Tour. Get all your favorite WWE gear like toys, DVDs, T-shirts, and more at Kmart.
Uh-oh.
Got caught right there.
Uh-oh, and
great counter there by Kane. And ladies and gentlemen, here comes Kane. Ooh, both superstars down. Turning point in the match as these two colossal superstars have taken each other off their feet.
Wait a minute.